verse 2, it's just telling us concerning the word which is the way we live in this world. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. I repeat, don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Amen. Amen. So Romans chapter 12 verse 1 up to 4 is telling us about so many things. But what we're going to talk about today, I want to talk about something very special. About a body. You ask me, why am I starting with the body? There is a reason. I'm starting with the body because the body has everything. And every person here has got a body. And the body has got members. And every part of the body has its functions. So that we can listen very good the message. I want everybody to follow me. I won't take much time. If we didn't finish at exactly 1 o'clock, I'll come. Because it's a short message, but very powerful. I want you to listen to it. The body has members of the parts. And if we look into the body, we will see there is a head. And if we look into the head, there is about 5 types of body. Five parts. Am I right or wrong? 5 parts on the head. There is ears. There is eyes. There is nose. There is mouth. And what else?
The brain. The brain.
Your chin, skin.
Your chin is on the head.
Or your cheeks. Or your eyebrows. Your tongue.
So your tongue, that means you've got your teeth on you as well. So.
Or there's just 4 parts that are
in your chin. There's a lot.
Okay. That's why I was asking. Was I right or wrong? How many parts are there in the head?
We don't know.
That is including the outside, the inside, or what? The what? Or just the whole brain in general, inside and outside? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the head.
The head?
Yes. There's a lot of things because there's the brain.
So are we talking, so inside as well, there's a lot of things inside?
Yeah.
Unless you talk about what you can see from the outside.
Yeah, that's what I see.
Okay, from the outside, you got your nose, you got your lips, you got your ears, your eyes.
Your
eyebrows. Yeah, you got your face, your hair.
Okay. The Bible says here, I'll repeat the words, on verse 4. For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office. That means, the person who is in the body of Christ has to have a mode of function. Now I'm talking about a head. The head of a person now. The things you can see physically with your eyes. The things which function. That's what we're talking about. How many? Can you mention them, please?
Your eyes, your ears, your lips, and your ears.
What is the work of the ears? What is the work of the eyes? What is the work of the nose? What is the work of the mouth?
Are you talking about the five senses?
Yeah, that's it.
Amen?
Amen.
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 So, if you have four parts in your head, everything has its function. Are we together? If everything has its function, now, today, I want us to take the nose out of your head. Today I want us to take the nose out of our head. Is it going to be head? Still?
No. It is still going to be head.
So that means you are telling me that those people who they cut their ears, it's not, they don't have head anymore.
They still have head.
Well, it's not possible for you not to have a nose because the nose is the way you breathe.
It is possible. Remember there was a child that was born with no nose.
You can breathe by your mouth.
You can breathe by your mouth.
Yeah, we can still breathe by your mouth.
Okay. Let's talk again. If a person doesn't have eyes,
it's still a head.
It's still a head. If a person doesn't have ears,
it's still a head.
Okay, if the mouth is sealed, it doesn't have a mouth.
It's still a head.
When you look at it, say, oh, his head, but he has no mouth. His mouth is sealed. That's what you're going to say, isn't it?
The only way you can't have a head is if it's been chopped off.
Yeah, that's the only way.
Wait, is it the person without all of this, or is it just they have their all features?
But one thing missing.
There is still a head.
It's still a head. Because when you look, I said, oh, what happened to your nose? You're going to have a nose. Yeah, you're gonna look at the head and you're like, oh, yeah, oh, poor guy, he hasn't got a nose. You know?
Okay, if we go to back to Africa, what do we call these people? If they're missing something on their head.
Okay.
What about in English? In England?
Disabled.
Why do they call them disabled?
Because they lack
something.
Because they lack something.
Yeah, they're less able to do certain stuff that somebody else would be fully, someone else could do appropriately.
Okay. Now, that means the person is disabled, he has the head. But he's missing something on that head. Amen? Now, the Bible is talking about the body. We come now with, I'm out of the head now, I'm on the full body. All the body full. Somebody has hands, legs, head, nose, all these things, and everything. Now he's lacking one hand. Does he have a body or he doesn't have a body?
Wait, you said hand or arm?
I say hand. What is the hand? That's it, yeah. I said the hand.
You need to follow me.
Okay, if I say the whole arm, I say arm.
No, but if you say hand, it indicates that they don't have the whole arm. Because without this, you technically don't have the hand. Some people
Okay, so what? Some people born with this, just this one. How are you gonna have that? How? You know somebody that just start off this by just go this?
They're not like that.
Amen. Hallelujah. No, we need to learn. We are learning. This is what the church is for. People are supposed to learn. If you didn't go to school, you didn't learn. The church should teach you as well. That's why I usually tell you, in the Bible, there is everything. When God was giving the word to his people, he was giving the word to educate us. And that's why you could see that Apostle Paul didn't go to school. Apostle Paul went to school, but Apostle John didn't go to school. Peter didn't go to school. They were the fishermen. They didn't tell you any theological college they went to. But the knowledge they had, the things they wrote here, is from the Spirit of the Lord. Are we together? So it doesn't mean that you go to school, then you learn everything. That's why the Bible says in Joshua, he said that this book of the law should not depart from your mouth. Meditate it day and night. Because there is everything you are looking for. Brother Theo is telling us that he has seen a person with a hand, without a arm, he walking. So he was having a hand here, and this one is not there, but he was walking.
This guy is stupid.
Are we together? But that person still has a body. So that means there was something which was connecting from the hand to the body. Are we together? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. To God be all the glory. So a person can walk only with the body and that feet without the leg.
Well, yeah, possible. Because still seeing one with no arm, so.
That's what the Theo is telling us. So somebody who has a feet and no leg, but he has a body. He's walking. There is something miraculously. He's connecting.
What did this guy see, bro? What does he see? His eyes are different to everyone's.
Amen. What is the Bible wants to tell us here? Brother, he has given us a very good passage to speak about. Brother Theo, it's impossible for you to see a person like that. If you see a person like that, run.
Mommy, like, you can still feel his hand here. He's still moving.
He can still feel his hand, still moving, but he doesn't have his arm. Theo, what are you saying? He's been watching too much that far.
If you see such a person, run. It's a ghost. That person doesn't exist. You never see a person walking on the street with a hand without an arm. And you see that person is a person. He's not a person. He's a ghost. That means he has a hand, he has a arm and hand, but he has just hidden his arm for you to fear him because he's a ghost. You can never see a person walking with the feet without leg. That's what you're telling us. So it's impossible. So the Bible is telling us here that body has so many parts. As the body has so many parts, each part has its function. His part has the work to do. So as the body we are talking about, if we transform it the other way, we are talking about a church. And the church we are talking about, let's take the church we are here today. This church is like a body of a person. It's like a body of somebody. And that body has parts. And what part are we talking about? There is the parts in the church that people has its own function to do. They have the work to do in the church. They have their part to do in the church. Because they are part of the church. They are part of the body. If you are a part of the body, you need to work as the way your work has been given to you. Amen. As Brother Theo is telling us that, the person who was walking without a leg, but he has a feet. Without an arm, but he has a hand. So that hand had a part to work, whether it had no arm. Is it possible? Can a feet walk without a leg? Can a hand function without an arm? Okay, it's the same. We are saying like a body can function without a head. It's the same thing. You take off the head, now the body starts walking around.
You know, I was reading somewhere. If this chop somebody's head, it takes six minutes.
That's takes about 6 minutes, not okay, for a day. You won't see a person walking a day without a head.
No, but you know, in that 6 minutes, you say, oh, there's a bucket there with no head.
Amen. Even if you chop the hand of a person, if it was moving, it was actually 6 minutes, it will move. It will do something. So, the church has the parts to work. Those parts are supposed to do things according to what they have been given the work to do. As the body. If you have a body, there is the head. What is the work of the head for a body to do? The head had so many things. There is the ears to listen. If a person has no ears on this body, that person will be deaf. And that's why they call them disabled. And if we see a person walking without a mouth, that person can never speak to you. Even though you converse with him, you never hear his voice. Why? He has no mouth to speak through. Amen. If a person has no eyes, yes, he's a person, but he's incomplete. He's not complete. He's a person who is lacking something in his life. And that's why the English people say that person is a disabled person. Because you have no eyes. If you don't have a leg, they say you are disabled. Why? Because you have no leg. You cannot walk right. If a person has no arm, it's the same thing, they call him a disabled. And that's why here, they have disability allowances to give to those people. Because they cannot function properly. Amen. Amen. We are still on the verse 4. Haven't yet touched verse 3. Haven't touched verse 4. Verse 2, the main verse. Haven't touched the verse 1. The main verse is verse 2. So if we are talking about the body, we are talking only about the church. Because as the Bible says, for as we have many members in one body, refers to every person who is in the body of Christ. And all members have not the same office. That means they don't have the same functions. So it's like a church. The body we are talking about is the body of Christ. Which is the body of Christ? The body of Christ is the church. The church we can talk about is the church as today we are. This is the body of Christ. And everything in the church has to have the part to play. And there is churches nowadays. There is church in these places we are living today. In this world we are living today. They have disabilities. They don't function well. lacking some other parts in their lives. Are we together?
Amen.
What is the church consist of? What is the church consists of? We are speaking to people. What is the church consist of? What is the church supposed to have?
I have a son and what is the
Come and say, it's your opinion. What is the church consists of? We are saying here as for us. As we have many members in one body, refers to every person who is in the body of Christ. So we are talking about the body of Christ. The body of Christ is what? It's the church. Because Jesus said, Peter on this rock, I will build my church. That means this is the body of Christ. And as the body of Christ, the body of Christ has many parts. And every part has its function to work. They're supposed to have services. Now, we are talking about the body of Christ, which is the church. What is the church consist of? We don't know. The church consists, first of all, the head. About governors, kings, and all the things. People are not supposed to be coming to church because they need to come to church. They need to come to church so they should have knowledge as well. We had knowledge at school, and we need to have knowledge at church as well. The church is supposed to teach things which people are supposed to learn. When they are living in the world, they know how to live for God. They knew how to live for the world. They knew how to live and earn money. Now they need to know how to live for God. And when they consist all these two things, they will live a successful life. Why? Because they have both knowledge of the world and both knowledge of the God, of God's things. Now we are talking about the body of Christ. The body of Christ is supposed to have the head. The body can never have, they can never live without head. We spoke about here. We spoke things here. We said, have you ever seen a person walking without a head? Brother Arnold said, you can see a person 6 minutes walking without a head. He's not a person anymore. Can a person be called a person without a head? So, a person can never be called a person if he doesn't have a head. That means a church can never be called a church if it doesn't have a head. Are we together?
Amen.
But a person can be called a person when he doesn't have a leg. Are we together?
Amen.
So a church can be called a church if it's lacks some other things. But if it lacks the head, that place is not a church anymore. A person can be a disabled. A church can be also a disabled. Now, the church we are having here, it needs to have a head. What is the head of a church? Or maybe should I change this question? Who is the head of the church? Who is the head of the church? Christ. So Christ is the head of the church. If the church doesn't believe on Christ, is it a church? Okay, if the church doesn't believe on the work of the cross, is it a church? Okay, if the church doesn't believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, is it a church? Okay, we'll finish there. We're going to continue next week. How many questions I ask? The first one? The second one? Is the if the church doesn't believe in Jesus, is it the church? Then, if they don't believe in the message, in the work of the cross, is it a church? Okay. And the last thing, so that means there is four questions. The last one. Who is the head of the church? Okay. If the church doesn't believe in Jesus, is it a church? If the church doesn't believe in the work of the cross, is it a church? Okay. If the church doesn't believe that Jesus is the Son of God, is it a church? How many questions? We'll continue the message next week.